A new preview version of Stable Diffusion XL has just been released, but I wanted to answer the most important question. Can it still make images of me as Guy Fieri? And are they better than the previous version? Spoiler alert, the answer is yes. The version of Stable Diffusion I'm using this time is version XL 0.9, which is a research version that Stability AI is releasing before the 1.0 version is available later this month. According to Stability AI, the new model promises better photorealism, enhanced image composition and face generation, improved aesthetics, and shorter prompts for descriptive imagery, which I think basically means that they added a line of code that automatically appends by Greg Rutkowski to the end of every prompt now. The last time I trained Stable Diffusion to make images of myself, I used a technology called Dream Booth. This time, I decided to use a LoRA instead, which stands for low-rank adaptation. It's a technology that can be applied to the cross-attention layers that relate image representations with the prompts describing them. Now, did I understand a single word of what I just said? Not really. But the important part is that I can make little images of myself doing whatever I want, and the files that I use to create those images are actually a lot smaller. So the LoRA takes like 50 megabytes, whereas the original Dream Booth size was more like 5 gigabytes. I wanted to compare some of the previous generations and see how they stacked up with the new version. So in the following examples, I tried to keep the prompts similar, but in some cases I needed to be a little bit more specific to get the results that I wanted. So let's check out some of the comparisons. Okay, so in this first example, this is me as a bounty hunter, and on the left is the 1.5 version, and on the right is newer SDXL 0.9 version. So you can see right away, I actually liked the version that 1.5 made, even though like some details like my face is really messed up. I thought it did a pretty good job with the suit and the lighting, in general style, but for the new version, I think it just did a really good job. Like, it gave me a really cool visor, and like my hair looks really good. Most of the time my hair does not look that good. And it's got some cool lighting effects, like there's this like lightsaber thing on my shoulder. I'm not really sure what that is, but it's emitting some light. So you can see like orange light on the left and blue light on the right. So it's actually a really good composition. So well done, new version. Moving on, we have me playing at a concert. And this old version has some issues, right? Like, there's a microphone going into my glasses, and my eyes look weird, my teeth look weird. It seems like there's maybe an eyeball inside my ear, or maybe that's like a monitor from the microphone. But yeah, it's generally not that good. This new version still has some issues as well. Like, I've got two hands. I've got two left hands in addition to my right hand. And I don't know, my eyes look kind of weird in this one as well, but it's still much better. Like, the lighting is much better. Aesthetically, it just looks a lot better than this old version. This is a image that I thought was really creepy in my original video, where he's just kind of staring into space, and yeah, he kind of creeped me out. In the new version, it looks more like me, although it seems like they made one of my eyes blue. But it seems to have lost some of the interestingness as well. I used the exact same prompt on this one, and I think I included like a Kodak Portra 400. So I'm not really sure why this new version is a little bit more boring. So I feel like in this case, the old version is actually a little bit better, or at least a little bit more interesting. This is one that totally failed on the previous version. So what I was trying to do was I was trying to make like a cool character portrait, like. Sometimes, if you're playing like Baldur's Gate, like the old one, you know, you could like put in your own character portrait. So I wanted to make like a D&D character portrait for myself. And this one didn't get it at all. But this one was actually kind of cool. Like, he's got cool armor and he doesn't really look like me, but, it's still cooler than the other one. This one, I was trying to test the fog effects. So, this one's got a case of the creepy eyes and teeth. And I think this one was the best one that I found, but it still is pretty bad. I think the fog is kind of cool, but it's not that good. In this newer version, you can just see the detail. Like, there's a lot more detail on the face, and the light is kind of reflecting off of the coat, and it just looks a lot better lighting-wise. Like, the lighting just looks a lot better. It's, like, more diffused. So I would say XL wins in this case. This is the Fortnite version of myself. I think generally, just speaking, like, it looks better with the new version. The old version just has fewer pixels, and so there's not as much information. And the new version just looks pretty good. I don't even play Fortnite, but I'm guessing this is what characters look like from my limited exposure to Fortnite. This is me as a knight in shining armor, and the old version looks like a sad version of me at like a Renaissance fair, and he got roped in by his friends, but he doesn't really want to be there. And then the new version is like, he's got cool hair, he still has his glasses, even though he's a knight, and his armor looks really rad. And it's pretty symmetrical too, so that's pretty good. Although I think the collar on the one side is bigger than the other, but that's okay. So I think definitely, you know, you've got like a cathedral in the background too. There's like a lot more detail on this one versus, yeah, I look like I'm at, you know, someone's backyard. So definitely XL wins in this case as well. This is my attempt to make a Matrix version of myself. I'm not really sure why the background in this one, it seems like it's like a really bad green screen or something, because there's like a halo around my head. Whereas the new version is just really cool. Like, this dude's cool. He's got cool sunglasses. He looks really mad for some reason. He's got cool hair. He kind of looks like me. There's like cool lighting in the background, and like the detail on the leather is really good as well. So this version is just much, much better. I mean, I guess there's like pretty good detail on this. Maybe there, you know, there's like some light reflecting, so that's pretty good. I don't know what happened to his neck. Maybe that's like a hickey or something. But yeah, definitely the new version is better. This one I tried to make like a naval officer painting of myself. I think I saw some painting somewhere else and I decided that was cool. So I wanted to see if I could make a painting of myself. This one, I look a little bit bored. This one I look bored too, but at least, you know, it's got like a real frame and there's like water in the background. And he's got a lot of medals, so I'm guessing, you know, that's what I would have if I was in the Navy. So again, you know, it just looks a lot better than the previous version. This one's like got some overexposure happening too. And again, bad teeth. Oh yeah, this is my version of the Nendoroid toy, so it's like an anime toy. I thought this version was okay, you know, but I think this version looks a lot better. It's got cool eyes. I think those are the eyes that, like, the Nendoroids have. I don't think these are really the same eyes. So the new version is just a lot better. He's got, like, a cool pose. He's got his hand in his pocket. So yeah, pretty good. This one, I don't know. I think the pixel art, I think the XL still struggles with the pixel art. And I think the old version is actually better than the new version, because the new version just seems like it's like one of those like old pixel game remasters where they like tried to upscale it, but they ended up adding like a lot of jagged lines and like diagonals and stuff. So neither of these are really that good, but I think the old version was at least a little bit better in terms of making it so that they were pixels. This one was one that I thought was really cool because I was trying to get like a transparent raincoat, which I thought would be really cool looking. This one looks like he's been out in the rain for a little bit too long, and he's not very happy about it. This one just seems like he's like really cool, but he's also getting wet. But yeah, I really like the effects here with like the light bouncing off of, you know, it looks like a plastic see-through sort of jacket, so I think it looks really cool. So there's some really good lighting effects going on. Okay, this one I tried to make like a Fabio version of myself. I don't think the original version could really handle it. And it just ended up making two of me, and they're hanging out with each other. So I don't know what kind of romance novel that one is, but I don't really want to be associated with that one. The newer version, I mean, it like basically made me like an Asian Fabio. And it gave me like an Asian girlfriend too. So that's kind of cool. And my hair looks really luscious. So I'm really liking this version. I'm gonna say that the SDXL version wins by a landslide here. Okay, let's move on. Oh yeah, I was trying to make like some tech bro images of myself. Like, you know, this is like me, the realtor. I'm gonna sell you a house. This version, it looks a little bit scary. His eyes are kind of weird and his teeth are kind of crooked, and He's even wearing, like, kind of a cheap suit jacket. I guess this one's kind of similar, too. But, you know, this one's in a much better place. His face is very smooth, too. So we've got that going. And I seem like I'm in some kind of, like, really industrial kitchen. So that's kind of nice. But here again, I think the new version definitely wins compared to the old version. This is me trying to make myself into Wolverine. And I feel like it's kind of hard to become Wolverine because it's hard for me to tell that it's supposed to be me. I mean, aside from the nose, it doesn't really look that much like me. Maybe the eyebrows. But the old version actually did a pretty good job of trying to make me look like Wolverine. So stylistically, I think the new version looks better. The lighting has much more detail in it, but both are pretty good. Okay, yeah, and this one, I tried to make myself a zombie, and in the prompt I said that part of my jaw was missing. But I don't know why Stable Diffusion has a hard time, like, getting rid of people's jaws. So they just, like, throw a lot of, like, blood on my face and call it a day. So this is the best that I could get as a zombie for both versions. So I'm not sure if there's, like, some sort of not safe for work filter on there that doesn't let me be a zombie. Or, you know, maybe there's not enough training images of me with my jaw off, which is probably a good thing. But... yeah, for some reason, the zombie hang is just not that good. I know that's the last one. So now let's talk about a few other things I noticed while going through and generating images through Stable Diffusion. So now I'll talk a little bit about weird things that I noticed while I was generating some of images in general. And I think some of these also apply to the older version of Stable Diffusion, but I don't think I really talked about them in my previous video. So one thing I noticed when I was generating images is somehow Stable Diffusion knows that I'm Asian. So this time, for my token, I actually used my name. Previously I used Jackie Chan and I used Sai, who are also Asian. I don't know if it knows that I'm Asian from my name, or if it's just like it sees my face and it's like, oh, that's an Asian guy. But when I started making images, it also started associating things with me that, like, were Asian. So for example, when I was creating the Fabio version of me, Stable Diffusion also liked to pair me up with Asian ladies, which kind of annoys my wife because she's not Asian. But, you know, it would be kind of creepy, I guess, if, like, she actually showed up without training at all. But that was kind of weird. Another weird thing that was happening was I was trying to make some red carpet, like, movie premiere photos of myself, like, as the actor, obviously. But I noticed in the background, all of the people, you know, who were standing behind me were also Asian. And so I don't know if this is, like, Stable Diffusion telling me that I should be in the next Crazy Rich Asians movie, which, you know, I'd be happy to be in there, in some minor role, like, you know, being rich. But, you know, it kind of strikes me as a little bit racist that, you know, if I'm an Asian at a movie premiere, somehow all the other people behind me are Asian. Like, I can't be in, like, a normal movie, you know, like The Avengers or some other non-only Asian people movie. So that's another point against Stable Diffusion for being racist. And then finally, there was this image I made of myself as, like, a naval officer painting or whatever. And then in the corner of one of them, like, there was Chinese writing. And I don't actually read Chinese, so I don't know if it was just gibberish or what. But that was kind of weird. Like, oh yeah, you want a picture of yourself as a naval officer. You're Chinese, let's put some Chinese in there. So yeah, I don't know if it's because of the token I used. I could try making myself just, like, I don't know, human or something, and see if that actually changes it. But then probably all the humans will look like me. So I'm not really sure what the best token uses. Not that I mind being associated with Asian stuff because I'm Asian, but I just thought it was kind of creepy and weird. So another weird thing that I've noticed was that whenever I would generate images, like, my weight would fluctuate, like, my face would be fat, and then it would be, like, skinny, and it would be, like, fatter. And it seemed to correlate with the kind of activities that I was doing. And so for, you know, some images, I was making myself eat ice cream. And so the images of me eating ice cream were all, like, me fat eating ice cream, or, like, a majority of them, my face was, like, a lot fatter. I seemed a lot pudgier for some reason. But then if I was out hiking and I was taking selfies, then for some reason, you know, selfie hiking version of me was thinner. So also the businessman version of me was really slim. And it's probably from all the coke that he has to do to like keep up with his high intensity lifestyle or whatever. But it was just kind of interesting. Like, it seems a little bit like weight-ist, for lack of a better word. So if you're doing something that involves eating, you're going to be fatter. And then if you're doing something that people kind of see as like a skinny person activity, then it makes you skinnier. So I thought that was kind of weird, but whatever. And also speaking of businessman me, he tends to have a gigantic Adam's apple. And I'm not really sure why it keeps on doing this. Like the previous version, I was also noticing that a lot of versions of myself would have like this giant Adam's apple, which I don't have in real life. And none of the training images that I used have a giant Adam's apple. So I'm not really sure where that is coming from, or if it's happening to other people. Like if you have your own trained versions of Stable Diffusion and your Adam's apple is also huge, like let me know, because maybe we can, you know, talk to Stability AI and raise this huge issue. Because I don't want to have to like put no Adam's apple in the negative prompt, you know, with a huge weight all the time. I just want to not have a giant Adam's apple. So as always, if you like this video, make sure to hit that like button. And if you want to see more videos like it, be sure and hit the subscribe button as well. And let me know in the comments if there's anything that I should have talked more about, or if there was anything that was kind of boring about the video, because I always want to try and make my videos better next time around. And in this video, I didn't really talk much about the training because it's still in the .9 version that's not official yet. But if you want to see more videos about the actual training process, let me know in the comments as well. And as always, I'll see you in the next video. And until then, happy image generating.